So before we're going to start the discussion, so I must be presenting this misconception about the flat disk, no? Flat disk Earth. No, so totoo mo nga flat disk ang Earth. So you must not be here, no. Wala mo dapat diri ah kay in geodesy or in science in as a whole, no nga Earth is not a flat disk. Dapat yun siya din a flat disk. It must be round. So flat disk was encircled by the ocean. So this was based from the idea of Homer's Iliad of 800 BC and the Thales of Milet of 600 BC. So unsa day forma sa flat disk? Kung flat disk ang Earth, unsa day forma? So this was the idea of the Homer's Iliad and the Thales of Milet. So ingani ang forma daw sa flat disk. So as you can see, naadriya ang Earth, then nakalibutan siya og land. Kaya ingani siya forma ang flat disk. Or pwede pa siya ingani, no? Si Earth, tapos mga awas ang tubig niya, dindri ang mag-revolve si Sun, si Moon. Si Sun pag diha siya moagi, so adlaw siya. Pag nasa ilalom si Sun is gabi E. Yan na ilang una. So another picture is this one. So kumutuo mo, nangana si Earth. So you must not be here in this class, because we are talking about the science, about the shape and size of them. Or it might be this one. Nadriya ang nadris Earth. Tapos kani is mga continents, then oceans. Nakalibutan din siya ang glaciers or snows. Tapos na island sa ilalo. So are you one of them? We have the what we called the Flat Earth Society. Tapos na po dyan sila yung Facebook page. Kita lang ako nga naamod dito sa kuan kanina Facebook group ay nabantay lang dyan. So first we're going to tackle about the first Earth model, which is the spherical Earth model. So nganong nakakonclude man ang mga scientists before na ang Earth is spherical model? So nasulay series of observation, and this first observation is the boat and the horizon. According to that observation, in the ancient seafarers, the Greeks and others must already have noticed that the boat coming from the horizon is not in full view, no? At once, or its superstructure is visible long before the hull is seen. So, makabantay mo or nakabantay masiguro mo anino kanang shall we say bangka or say barko na lang, no? And daka sa shoreline tapos kani is sea. Samtang magkalayo ang bangka or ang boat, no? Ang imo na lang makita ni isang tumoy na lang na part sa bangka. So dili na siya pasabot niya kung gamay na lang imong makita, no? Gamay na lang imong makita nga portion sa bangka is nahulog na to siya or nawala na to siya. So according to the first observation, no, the Earth is round, no? Okay? Subay ang bangka or ang boat sa shapes of Earth, which is round, and that is spherical. Second observation is traveling north at night. According to this observation, that traveling north at night, the North Pole star, or kanang itawag na itong Polaris is the North Star, appears to get higher in the sky as measured from the horizon up. And in the figure above, the angle 2 daw is larger than the angle 1. So nakita nimo, nakadriya first, no? Imusaka ka sa north hemisphere, padulong sa north hemisphere. No, so driya mas gamay pa ang imong angle kay mo ni imong horizon. Kabalo mo sa horizon plus kada imong makita, no? Kada imong makita nga tawag ani. Yung horizon kada makita nimo na sa kung nagtindog ka, so ang panamakita nimo, that's your horizon. So from that horizon padulong daw sa North Star mo ni imong angle. Pero when you traveling padulong sa North hemisphere, say for example na nakadiria. So ang imong angle is ang angle sa horizon ni mapadulong sa North Star, which is ang Polaris, is mas dako compared sa imuhang horizon at this point. From that observation, nakaingon sila nga spherical ang Earth. The next observation is traveling north by day. Adlaw na pod. Okay, na kay night man to, no? So traveling north by day, a man shadow at moon becomes longer. So kung nakadiria nga portion sa Earth, no, ang imuhang ang strike sa sun is paana man. So ang imuhang shadow is shorter than the nakadiria sa kaning diria nga part sa Earth. At same time compare nimo ang isa ka tawo na adiria sa let's say naa sa may middle na padulong na sa equator, no, kaniya po sa isa kay naa sa mga 60 degrees latitude north, no. So same time mag-observe mo, i-compare ninyo. So ang shadow sa dapit sa may equator is shorter than the person standing in the north 60 degrees north latitude. So mas longer ang iyahang shadow. So that's the third observation, why the Earth is spherical. So realizing that the Earth daw is curved based sa katong mga observation, people jump into the conclusion that it is curved equally all over like as a sphere. So katong ang mga observation motoy nagdala sa ilahang idea, nakaingon sila nga ang Earth is curved and that curve is equal and that's a sphere. Then the next question arises after the spherical Earth model. How big is that sphere? Kwaron, kung sphere si Earth, unsa ni nakadako ang sphere? So kailan ba mo ani niya from GE100 or GE101 or kani? Yes, he is Eratosthenes. No? Siya si Eratosthenes. And si Eratosthenes, before pa sa iya ha, naa si Pythagoras, no? Which is from 580 to 500 before Christ. And his school, na iskwilahan si Pythagoras, as well as Aristotle, among others, expressed themselves for the spherical shape. So we all know nga si Eratosthenes, siya ang first nga nag-calculate sa circumference na sa Earth and also the radius. So, but before that, naanay mga expressions or naanay mga ideas before si Pythagoras and Aristotle na ang Earth daw is a spherical shape. So the founder of scientific geodesy is Eratosthenes, no? Si Eratosthenes of Alexandria, who under the assumption of the spherical Earth deduced from the measurement of a radius for the Earth. And the principle of arc measurement, maoyang gigamit na method to develop by himself, was still applied in the modern ages, which is pinakaduol mampud na approximation ang gibuhat ni Eratosthenes, the arc measurement method. So here is the illustration, balik ani nga illustration, no? So since na naman ni sa inyo hang GE100, no, I guess ninyo na discuss naman ni sa inyo ha. So, the illustration on how Eratosthenes measured the circumference of the Earth and the radius of the Earth. So, Eratosthenes at the well, no, at Syene or Syene, no, Eratosthenes had observed that on the day of the summer solstice, the midday sun shone at the bottom of a well in the ancient Egyptian city of Suenet, so, or known in the Greek as the Syene or Syene. And Alexandria also know that at that instant, same day, no, at Alexandria here, no, muna siyang Alexandria, he knew that at the same time, the sun was not directly overhead, no, at Alexandria. Instead, though, it cast a shadow with a vertical equal to 1 over 50 of the circle or the 7 degrees and 12 minutes ang iyang equivalent. So, maoni siya, no, ang shadow, no, ang 7 degrees and 12 minutes. And also, Eratosthenes knows that Alexandria and Syene were 500 miles apart. So from this observation, Eratosthenes concluded that the circumference of the Earth is 50, okay, 1 over 50 man to siya na arc measurement. So 1 over 50 of the full circle. So that is the 50 times 500 miles, or it was approximately 25,000 miles ang circumference sa Earth. And the accepted value along the equator is 24,902 miles. But if you measure the Earth through the poles, kay since the Earth is a oblate spheroid, yes, oblate spheroid, mas dako ang iyang circumference sa equator compared sa axis niya katong sa meridian. So yung from mas dako ang circumference sa along east to west than the north to south. So, but if you measure the Earth through the poles, the value is 24,860 miles. So, Eratosthenes was within 1% of today's accepted value. And Eratosthenes' conclusions were highly regarded at that time. And his estimate of the Earth's size was accepted for hundreds of years afterwards. Siya may first, no? Tapos, mas dool po siya sa exact na value. And Eratosthenes, using the arc measurement, so nagamit siya geometry and some trigonometric functions to derive the circumference of the Earth. So, Eratosthenes' observations on the spherical Earth model is, he first knew that there was a place called Syene, now Aswan, no? South of the Alexandria, that where the sun rays reach at the bottom of the deep well at noon at the same day. And he know that he knew how many days it took a camel caravan to travel the distance between Syene at Alexandria. So mo na iyang pamaagi kung yun sa to siya pag-calculate ang 500 miles. Now, so inibawaan niya nga pila ka days maabot ang camel caravan to travel a distance between Syene and Alexandria. So out from that number of days, do the calculations, then he arrived at 500 miles ang Syene to Alexandria. And also, Eratosthenes is knowledgeable about geometry. Okay, di man siya maka-arrive at ito na conclusion kung wala siya nagamit o formula sa geometry. And here is the illustration on the how Eratosthenes measured the Earth. Measured the circumference of the Earth, rather. And for this video, so so I'll be going to attach this to the LMS for the separate video. So, tanawa lang ninyo kung saan this video is about the spherical shape of the Earth. And now let's go to the ellipsoidal Earth model. So, manamanta sa sphere. So, let's go na to the ellipse na Earth model. So, in the 17th century, it was possible to measure distances and gravity precisely. This is enough to notice that the curvature of the Earth was not the same at different places. So, in this century, 17th century, possible na ang pag-determine sa distances and gravity. Gravity sa nga mas precise compared sa una. So, na notice nila na at different places, lahi-lahi o sa man, the Earth is not the same. No? The curvature of the Earth is not the same at same places. So, this meant to say that the Earth daw is not a sphere at all. No? Kay, dili man siya same o kaya kung ngayon magutag sphere, at any point on that sphere, dapat same iyang curvature. No? Kanang, kung ngayon tag curvature is the change in x, the change in y over the change of x, or kanang itawag ito derivative of x, derivative of y over derivative of x. No? So, kung same na sila, curvature, So that's a proof nga ang Earth is a sphere kay equal man ang iyahang curvature, pero they notice nga dili siya same. So this meant to say that the Earth daw was not a sphere after all. So kung dili siya sphere, so unsa man siya, unsa naman pud siya karon? What else could it be? So dili naman siya sphere. So basid kani nga ni forma, like since we are ellipse, ellipse mga pun siya, di ba? Or basid kani ellipse man siya. And there are two countries no during that this time na nag-argue about the real shape of the shape of the Earth if it is not a sphere, no? So kaya nabantayan nila hindi man sphere, so dili pud siya equal. So base ning ani daw forma, according sa French, ingani daw forma nga pagka ellipse ang Earth, mo siyang egg. And according to British, ingani pud ang forma sa French is flatten daw ang Earth at the equator. Flatten ang Earth at the equator. According to British, flatten ang Earth at poles, North Pole and South Pole. So there are mauni lang mga arguments. So ang tawag atong sa French na argument is prolate daw ang ellipse. Prolate ang ellipse, which means to say flattened at equator. And according po sa British, oblate daw. Oblate nga ellipse. So, pag may tag-oblate, flattened at the poles. So, mauni siya ang forma. No? Prolate daw ni according sa French. And this is oblate at British. So, sa in French, no, they measure distances at France. And they were convinced that the Earth was pointed towards the poles like an egg. And according sa British, so the British had Newton's new theory of gravitation. So nagbase sa ataga British sa theory ni Newton, which is the theory of gravitation, and they were just as convinced that the Earth was flattened at poles like a grapefruit. From the arguments of two countries, now, there is an international dispute aroused when so-called Earth elongators were pitted against the Earth flatteners. So, ang Earth elongators is katunisyang sa French, and Earth flatteners are the British one. So, to dissolve this dispute, no, the French Academy of Sciences decided in the magnificently simple way to solve the argument by sending one expedition to Lapland in the north, and the other is Peru, no? To Peru near the equator, measure and compare the arcs. Okay. So ang isa north, ang isa is ang along the equator. Sa Lapland is ang north, sa equator is ang Peru. So i-compare na sila ang ilahang na measure nga arcs. And this is the basis, no, if kung kinsay mudaog, no, between the French and the British, na if a 1 degree arc daw, no, 1 degree arc rather in the north were shorter than a 1 degree arc near the equator, then the French would be right. No, anong mas shorter man ang 1 degree, kay since diba si French is ang iyang pagtuo is prolate, no, pag muintag prolate, mas flattened siya at equator. No, pag flattened ang equator, was mas longer ang iyahang 1 degree arc compared sa padulong sa north. And vice versa, no, if the arc daw kuno in the north were longer, the British would be right. Okay? Si British, nagtuupod siya na si Earth is oblate. No? Pag oblate is north, ang north and south poles are flattened. Flattened at the north and south poles. So, it turns out, no, na si British were right. And the Earth daw kuno was flatter at the poles. Maunang ato ang Earth model as ellipsoid is oblate, is ellipsoid, oblate siya. A flattened Earth model or oblate ellipsoid has been used since that solution of the argument. So the ellipsoid daw as an Earth model, if an ellipse is rotated about its minor axis, it forms an ellipsoid of revolution. So we are going to imagine na it is a simple ellipse, no? Kabalaman taon sa ellipse. Ay siyang forma. Oblate, no? Oblate siya ng ellipse. And, imagine na naamoy gigunitan ng piece of paper, tapos na asya'y somewhere stick sa inyong tunga-tunga, tunga-tunga sa inyong ellipse, and patuyo ko ninyo siya sa katong axis na katong na-stick. So, ang mabuwan na niya ng volume is ang itawag na ito nga ellipsoid of revolution. And the customary ellipsoidal Earth model has its minor axis parallel to the rotational axis of the Earth. So, pag maingon taog oblate ellipsoid, ang iyahang minor axis, pag maingon tag minor axis, ang gamay nga axis, major pod is ang dako nga axis. So, in this case, for oblate ellipsoid, ang iyahang minor axis is denoted as 2B. And parallel daw siya sa Earth's rotational axis. The size of such ellipsoid is usually given by a length of two semi-axis or the semi-major axis and the flattening. So, ang iyang parameter ani class is determined by first a semi-major axis, kaning A. Next is ang semi-major axis. Patunga lang siya sa minor axis mo na siya from the center padulong dito sa north or south. So, B na siya, semi-minor axis. And sa semi-major axis, from the center padulong sa equator. And ang flattening, which is A minus B over A, or semi-major axis minus semi-minor axis all over semi-major axis. Next Earth model is the geoid. When the satellite data were analyzed further, so the birth of the geoid model is discovered and analyzed by the satellite data. As it turned out, that the nearest point in the Earth's satellite's orbit, or kinagitawag na to og perigee, was always nearer to the Earth when the satellite was over the northern hemisphere than when it is over the southern hemisphere. This indicates that the asymmetry of the Earth's shape. So, nabantayan na itong during na ana ang katong nga satellite. Same on yung Earth. Ang orbit sa satellite is kani. Ana siya. So, nabantayan daw na perigee, or ang satellite mas dool sa Earth, ang tawag ana niya is perigee. Satellite is nearer with respect to Earth. Perigee ang tawagan na niya. Mas dool daw ang satellite sa Earth in the northern hemisphere. No? And it turns out na it will go further, mas layo siya compared diri sa northern hemisphere. Southern hemisphere po, mas layo siya. Mas layo ang satellite with respect to the Earth. No? Pag dool, perigee. Tapos pag abot diri sa southern, layo na siya, ang tawag na pud ana is apogee. APOGEE, apogee tawag ana niya. No? So nabantayan na this indicates daw that there is an asymmetry, no, of the Earth's shape. So kunting trivia lang, no. When satellite is nearer with respect to Earth, no, ang tawag ana niya is apogee or moon, no, si moon pud siya. Basta with respect to Earth, ang tawag ana niya is perigee, no. Pero pag layo, apogee. No? Same as kung sa Earth na pud with respect to sun, kung mas dool si Earth kay sun, no, with respect to sun, ang tawag is perihelion, no. Helion kay ano man, sun man, helion sun. So perihelion, tapos pag layo, that's aphelion. No? Aphelion. A-P-H-E-L-I-O-N. Aphelion. So, it's a little narrower daw in the north than the south. So, muna akong discuss na ganina. In ellipsoid, we obviously do not mean the shape produced by the mountains and valleys and topography. Yes, it's right, diba? Yung ellipse is smooth man siya. So wala na to siya gi take into consideration ang mga mountains, valleys, or ang topography as overall. Since we can measure the elevations in places above mean sea level, this is what they recorded on topographic maps. We can discount them and inquire into the shape of what is left, diba? So kung naanatay mean sea level or geoid, so wala na to siya gi-take account ang elevation. So elevation minus the height, ang mabilin na lang is ang sea level. Sea level, or pag naapod sa landforms, ang katong sea level extended padulong sa landforms. That's the geoid. So that is the sea level surface itself, as if it were extended from the seashore into the land areas without those elevations above it. So may akong discuss di kaganina, no? From the sea level surface or mean sea level surface extended into the landforms without elevations above it. So, terrain minus elevation, ang mabiling na lang muna siya mabiling sa sa geoid, no? Geoid na surface. So, this sea level surface is also called as a geoid. Muna akong discuss kaganina na. And the earth of the shape of the geoid is what we mean by the figure of the earth. Ito, mabiling, imagine na to na sea surface extended padulong sa landforms, no? Hantod na makonek siya, connect. And kana nga surface is what we call the geoid earth model. So again, baliktaan din na illustration, we have topography of the earth, tapos natay ellipse and geoid. So si geoid karon is from sea level, mean sea level extended padulong dito sa landforms. Magdepende po na siya sa density sa topography of the land. Density mo nang isa ka siya diha kay less iyang density, and iubos siya diri kay mas high ang iyang density. And pag ma-form na siya tanan, ma-form na siya, ma-connect na siya, then that's what we call geoid. So, baliktaan ni, no? There are three heights introduced in this Earth model. We have orthometric height. It's the height from the geoid. Let's say, for example, in this illustration, yung tahay na akad rin nagtindog. Orthometric height, or denoted as big H, no? Big H is the distance along the plumb line. So, pagpapamintag plumb line, kung asa ang direction sa imong gravity towards the earth. So, from the kanagtindog, ang imong orthometric height is the distance from the terrain sa imong itindogan padulong sa geoid along the plumb line. So, next is the ellipsoidal height. No? Ellipsoidal height is the distance from the point to the ellipsoid. So, it's assume nga nakakadiri mga point. So, ellipsoidal height is the from the earth surface going to the ellipsoid. And lastly is the geoidal separation or geoidal undulation. So, geoidal undulation is from the separation between the geoid and the ellipsoid. Si N. And in geodetic surveying, a reference surface is introduced in order to distinguish the curvilinear coordinates and heights. So, para ma-determine ang height, no? So, given ang imuhang ellipsoidal height, kay usually, pag GNSS receiver imong gamiton to get the heights, naka-ellipsoidal na siya, ng ellipsoidal. Then, given ka sa imong mean sea level, no? Or gusto ni mo kuhaon ang imuhang mean sea level, so dapat known imuhang geoidal undulation. So pag ma-known imong makuha man pud ni si geoidal undulation through the geoid model, no, kanang itawag na to og PGM or PGM, Philippine Geoid Model. So from that website no, makakuha kadto mga values of the n, g given na si N para makuha na to si height from the geoid, which is the mean sea level. And the geoid, with its irregular ups and downs, makes one think rather of the irregular potato than appear. No? So, kung tanawin mo, kung maoni si geoid, so, imong mahuna-huna, irregular dyan siya. No? Mura siyang potato. So, dili siya pear, no? Dili siya pear shape. Mura siyang potato. Irregular ang shape. To describe this shape, we use the ellipsoid, no? As an approximation. But, we have to pick one of the right size and shape. No? So, lahi-lahi nga countries, lahi-lahi na ellipsoid ang i-adapt. So, like this one, no? Kung maoni ang geoid, naay duha ka ellipsoid. Ang kaning isa, kani. And the second one is kani. No? So, matanaw ni mo, nga kaning sa first na ellipsoid, mas mo fit in siya sa North America. No? North America. And ang kanipod na ellipsoid is mo fit in siya sa Europe. Monang, in every countries, there are different ellipsoid yung gigamit. Ellipsoid model. So, lahi-lahi na sila. Kay, magdepende siya kung asa siya mo fit in. Noon sa Philippines, lahipod na ellipsoid ang gigamit. Clark, 1866 ang ginagamit na ellipsoid. And in this figure, an ellipsoid that fits very well, for instance, in America, does not necessarily fit in the Europe. So, maoni siya. Maoni siya. Kung i-discuss ka ganina. And here are the different ellipsoids, no, used as basis for mapping in various parts of the world. Maapod niya ang mga parameters. Si may major axis o si flattening. We have Airy, Everest, Bessel, Clark. So, sa Philippines, maon yung gigamit, no? Si Clark 1866, which na siya ay si may major axis niya 6378-206.4. Huwag iyang inverse flattening niya 294.98. Dapat tayo Clark 1880, International 1924, Karsovsky 1940, International Astronomical Union of 1968, WGS 72, GRS 80, and WGS 84. Kanipon sa WGS 84, this is the worldwide adapted ellipsoid. Worldwide. So, anapon siya parameter nga si may major axis nga 6378137 o ang flattening nga inverse flattening rather 298.2572. So, we were going to recall now about geodetic datum. So, geodetic datum is a set of parameters that describe the relationship between a particular local ellipsoid and a local geodetic reference system. So, a geodetic datum is defined by a set of at least 5 parameters, namely the semi-major axis of the reference ellipsoid, the flattening, and the x, y, and z coordinates of the ellipsoid's origin with respect to the geocenter. So, anong kinahanglan siya x, y, and z? Kasi geodetic datum will be the basis for the origin, no? The origin of that system. The origin of the geodetic reference system to become, to be used, no? By the survey ginakandak at your local, no? So, kinahanglan siya na ay particular relationship between local ellipsoid and the geodetic reference system. Since we all know nga, in different countries, is dapat na-adjud siya ay datum. And, geodetic datum is a set of parameters and constant that defines a coordinate system, including its origin, its orientation, and scale, in such a way as to make this accessible for geodetic applications. There are types of geodetic datum, namely the horizontal geodetic datum. This is for horizontal geodetic control in which points are mapped into the specified ellipsoid. So, pag mayingon ta og horizontal, it's merely for horizontal control, the establishment of a geodetic datum for horizontal geodetic control. So, pag mayingon ta og horizontal two-dimensional. And this datum is a two-dimensional, as what I have said a while ago, in the sense that two coordinates, the latitude and longitude, are necessary and sufficient to identify a point. Diba? Pag naatay latitude and longitude, we can specify the location of the specific point. And we have next type is the vertical geodetic datum. It's a geodetic datum for vertical geodetic control, in which points are mapped in a geopotential. And this datum is only one-dimensional and requires the value of a single parameter, so which is the origin of the point to be reliable. So example ani niya is ang mean sea level. So there are examples of horizontal geodetic datum. We have the WGS-72, WGS-84, and PRS-92. So, mani siya ang example for geodetic datum. And for vertical datums, we have the mean sea level. Mean sea level. So, ano siya mean sea level? Kaya ay tawag na low tide, nagkuntay high tide. Pero, kuha ko na to ang mean out ana niya. So, dili po ta basta-basta makabuhat o mean sea level, no? Or maka-create of mean sea level, guys. Because, the creation of the mean sea level takes 19 years, no? 19 years continuous observation para makakuha taan na mean sea level. So, these are the datums, no? Geodetic datums used by different countries. So, ang kaning inganig forma ng legend niya is mauni siya. So, ang tawag na niya is North American datum. Ang uban kay European, kanisya, apoy Tokyo, Indian, and so on and so forth. So, for this video about datum, so, since di na ko siya ma-play diri, so, I'm going to attach the video in the in our LMS, no, for you to have the video. I hope nga inyo siyang tanawon para masabtan ninyo kung unsay pasabot sa datum. And let's go to the reference systems and reference frames. So, it's a recall again. It's this is discussed in your geometric geodesy, no? So, reference system is a complete conceptual definition on how a reference coordinate is formed. And it defines the origin and orientation of fundamental planes and axes of this system. So, pag may reference system, is the whole conceptual, the concept of the system. And it also includes the underlying fundamental mathematical and physical model. So, since kay so concept pa man siya, so, ang basis niya is, or ang fundamental niya is ang mathematical and physical models. And when we say reference system, is it is an attached, no? An attached to the real world. Kay since conceptual pa siya, floating pa siya, no? Wala pa siya na-realize. And that realization is what we call reference frame. It's a practical realization of a reference system through observations. It realizes the reference system by means of coordinates, no? Coordinates of definite points that are accessible directly by occupation or observation. It consists of a set of identifiable fiducial points on the sky, like stars and quasars, or on Earth's surface, example, for the mental station. So, si reference frame ko ang mo-realize, no? Another simple scenario or simple analogy, no? Simple analogy of reference system versus reference frame is kanang si reference system is mura na siya o kanang resita sa doktor. Resita. Concept pa na siya gikan sa doktor nga mauni ang makaayo sa imong sakit. Sa prescription na siya, prescription. And now kung since kay concept pa man siya, i-realize na nimo once mapalit na nimo na ang tambal. So ang kanang tambal karon mo na siya ang reference frame. Kumbaga ang kanang reference frame mo realize sa reference system. So masoon pag-realize sa reference frame. Through monuments, kanang mga BBMs, geodetic control networks and stations, out of that system. Useless reference frame kung wala si reference system. And vice versa. Useless po si reference frame kung wala si reference system. And in practical surveying, we are only concerned with reference frames. Of course, kay, ito lang ito mag-base sa ito ang survey, no? Sa mga monuments. But underlying concept of a specific reference frame are fundamental importance. Of course, no? Sa akong pang-iingon, useless sa reference frame kung wala si reference system. And vice versa. So, another analogy of the reference system versus reference frame is this chessboard and chess pieces. No? So, without a reference frame and coordinates of control points are like chess pieces without a chessboard. So, atong ipalagay nga, ang kaning chess pieces is mauni siya ang reference frame. And ang kaning chessboard is ang reference system. So, kung wala daw ni si chess pieces, is useless ni si chessboard. So, kung may gamit niya, kung wala ni chess pieces. And vice versa, no? So, useless po ni si chess pieces kung wala po ni si chessboard. Or si chessboard kung wala si chess pieces. So, they can be arranged, analyzed, and moved, but they have no meaning. Okay? Kung nakaaning mga pieces, chess pieces, so i-move-move lang nimo into this direction kung ang sa iyahang movement, pero wala ka balo, aha na siya padulong, no? So, regular direction ang imuhang buhat kung wala ang chessboard. So, useless ang reference frame kung wala ang reference system and vice versa. So, for the relationship between the reference system, geodetic datum, and reference frame are from the reference system, no, which is the whole concept of the a system. So, example of reference system is the terrestrial reference system. Output niya is ang geodetic datum by realization of the reference frames. And from that geodetic datum, horizontal datum, example niya, so, kung nanatay geodetic datum, nanatay reference sa itong origin, and from reference datum, we will now having the reference frame, the realization of the reference system. Out from the geodetic datum, we can create a reference frame like GCP, benchmarks, and BLLMs. So, here are the example of some ellipsoids, no? In that was used in today. So, naay Airy, si Bessel, si Clark 1866, Clark 1880, Clark 1880 nga modified, Everest, and so on and so forth. So, we have also these datums that will use that was used across the world. Daghan kay ni sila class, isa-isa ko na lang yung nagbasa ha, kamo na bahalaan. So, we have also there Indian, and in the Philippines, we have Luzon. Luzon datum. Ang iyang ellipsoid is si Clark 1866. So, daghan kayo ni sila class, kaman na magbasaan. So, let us also recall the basic parameters of an ellipse. Na. So, out from this illustration, si F1 o si F2 are the foci of the ellipse. And O is the center of the ellipse. And si line OA, and line OB are the A. Equal siya sa A, which is also called semi-major axis of the ellipse. And then also O to P1 and O to P2 are denoted as B, which is the semi-minor axis of the ellipse. And P1 and P2 is the minor axis. No? P1 to P2 is the minor axis of the ellipse. While P is the arbitrary point of the ellipse. No? Unit na siya as P kay siya ang, for example, the eye point niya. And it is a constant, no, nga si A, F2 to P1 plus F1 plus F1 to P is equal to 2A. Dapat 2A ni siya plus 2A. No? Kani plus kani is equals to 2A. And wala nga na siya 2 plus. Wala nga na siya 2. Ah, okay. Naraday siya. So, a constant pala. Asabot ka ganina is a constant. Pili day siya. A niya, semi-major. So, constant siya along the points of the circumference of the ellipse. Sa asa nga point kung diri si P equal lagi ako na siya nga si F2 to P plus F1 to P is equals to 2A lagi ako na siya. 2A. Twice of the semi-major axis. For the parameters of the ellipsoid, we have flattening, no? First, the parameter is flattening. Flattening is the measure of compression of a circle or a sphere along the diameter to form an ellipse or an ellipsoid of dimension respectively. So kung naay compression, mahimo siyang ellipse. Okay. From the circle, i-compress siya, no? Okay. Since ato ang Earth is oblate spheroid, so i-compress na siya to i-compress siya sa polar, no? Polar na axis. Other terms for flattening is ellipticity or oblateness. Then usual notation for flattening is F, and its definition in terms of semi-axis of the resulting ellipse or ellipsoid is compression factor, which is minor axis over semi-major axis in each case. Flattening, the compression, link word there is compression. And there are also two other variants of flattening. And to avoid confusion, the term flattening is also called as first flattening. Naido ang klase ng good na flattening. So, first flattening and second flattening. So, pag ma-avoid ang confusion, flattening is also equal to first flattening. So, it is defined as a difference in magnitude between semi-major axis A and semi-major axis B divided by semi-major axis. For the Earth, no, the semi-major axis and semi-minor axis is differed about 21 kilometers. So since kay oblate na to ang Earth, oblate ellipse or oblate spheroid, so mas dako jud si major axis daw. So semi-major axis daw compared to semi-minor, nag-differ siya og 21 kilometers. So first flattening, mao ni ang formula, no, F denoted as F. So semi-discuss gini sa formula. Semi-major axis minus semi-minor axis all over semi-major axis. We have also second flattening. So butangan na siya o. Nalang siya guhit sa taas gamay. No? F prime. No? F prime ang tawag na niya. F prime is ma-change lang ang same lang siya sa first flattening. Pero para mas dali siya ma-memorize, parihaan lang sa first flattening, i-change lang ang ubos o semi-minor axis. So, ang formula niya is semi-major axis minus semi-minor axis all over semi-minor axis. So, kalain lang nila is si B na ang ilalong sa second flattening. So, for notation of an ellipse, no? So, balik taan niya figure. So, F2 to P1 plus F1 plus P1 is constant na siya as 2A. Muna yung A, isa pagid ka A, so 2A na siya. And, kaninga value from O to F2 or O to F1 is denoted as this formula. Square root of A squared minus B squared or semi-major axis squared minus semi-minor axis squared. So, kada siya nga notation, kada nga formula, is what we call eccentricity. Now, eccentricity is a ratio describing the shape of a conic section, or other term, the ratio of distance between foci to the length of the major axis. Distance between the foci to the length of major axis. So, balik ta. Mauni siya ang distance, no? Distance. And this distance is denoted with this formula, square root of a squared minus b squared. Now, ang pasabot sa eccentricity, distance between foci to the length of the major axis. And a circle, sa eccentricity is a circle is an ellipse with zero eccentricity. Pag zero ang eccentricity, circle na siya. Pag sa ellipse, 1 ang eccentricity. A circularity that has a different center or deviates from circular path. Another definition is the ratio of the distance between the center and the focus of the ellipse or a hyperbola to its semi-transverse axis. So here is the illustration of an ellipse and hyperbola with a constant A and the changing of eccentricity. So as you can see, from this point, which is the center, as it's go farther, padalong sa... So, kanin mo po niya mga focus naman siya din yun, kanin small dots. So, muna yung focus. So, kung nagkalayo siya sa center, mahimo na po siyang hyperbola. So, pag naadiri sa origin, which is zero, circle pa siya. No? Pero pag nanagani siya ay distance between focus, mahimo siyang ellipse, ellipse hangtod sa mahimo siyang hyperbola. So, that's the relationship. Ay, since, di ba, ang meaning ang eccentricity, no? Change, so the change of eccentricity is mag-differ siya, no? sa length of the focus, no? Over the major axis or ang iyahang A. So, muna siya. So, eccentricity, we have this formula, the first eccentricity, which is, di ba, morning defined ganina, the distance between the focus to the center. So, i-denote siya as C. No? Okay, balik taan niya figure. Saan ito, okay? Balik taan niya figure. No? Kung mauni si A, mauni si A, eh, di ba, balik taan itong formula nga. Pag si F2 to P1 plus F1 to P1 is equal to 2A. Na kung 2A ni silang duha, tapos A ni siya, okay, syempre duha man, natunga pa yun siya, na yung patong ipalagay niya na dali si point. So kung A ni siya, dapat A po ni dire. No? And we have this semi-major axis, semi-minor axis rather, so B ni siya. So kung A ni, tapos B ni, i-denote na ito ni siya as C. No? And C is equal to square root of A squared minus B squared from the Pythagorean theorem. So, balik ta sa formula. So, from the formula, so C is the ratio daw po, no, of the length of the focus and the origin, with respect to the origin, divided by the semi-major axis. So, sa C, kabaluman ta nga, ang equal ni C is, muna siya, square root of A squared minus B squared, i-over lang nato si A. Or, pwede po siya yung aning na form. E squared is equals to A squared minus B squared over A squared. And we have also this second eccentricity. No? Notated as E prime. No, na lang siya ay kuhan sa taas. Guhit. So, ang kalainan lang is over B na siya. Pag second eccentricity. First eccentricity is major axis. Second eccentricity is B na siya from minor axis. C to C over B. So again, C is square root of A squared minus B squared all over B. So pwede po siya ingani. A prime squared, A squared minus B squared over B squared. So balik taan ni, we have also this angular eccentricity. So balik taan ni na figure, we have this angle. Kanina angle. Kanang angle is what we call angular eccentricity. So, si A alpha. So, we have three trigonometric functions with respect to angular eccentricity. We have sine A. No, sine A. We all know nga, sine A is opposite over hypotenuse. So, umuunin si angular eccentricity opposite. Kani, O to F1. So, this is denoted as C, di ba? C over hypotenuse nga A. So, tawag na siya og angular eccentricity with respect to sine. C over A is also equal to first eccentricity. First eccentricity. Na E squared is equals to A squared minus B squared over A squared or square root of A squared minus B squared over A. No. So, si sine A di, sine alpha, so, angular eccentricity with respect to sine is also equal to first eccentricity. We have also cos angular eccentricity with respect to cosine. Balik punta sa katong figure, cosine. No? Cosine is opposite, adjacent over hypotenuse. Adjacent over hypotenuse. So, mauna si angular, adjacent B over hypotenuse na A. So, B over A na siya. So, B over A or equal to 1 minus flattening. And we have also this angular eccentricity with respect to tangent. Tangent code is opposite over adjacent. Opposite niya is C, diba? Sa itong figure kaganina, C and ang iyahang adjacent is B. So we have, we all know nga si C is ang square root of A squared minus B squared all over B. So, equal lagi ako na siya sa second eccentricity. So, tangent, angular eccentricity with respect to tangent pi is equal siya sa second eccentricity. So, I guess nasabta ninyo, no? So, balik punta sa notation of ellipse. Kanina figure. So, we have also what we called linear eccentricity. So, linear eccentricity is the distance between the center and either of its two foci. The eccentricity can be defined as the ratio of the linear eccentricity to the semi-major axis. No, axis A. So, pasabot sa linear eccentricity, distance lang siya. Distance between center and either of its two foci. So, therefore, the I, so center to either of its two foci. So, center padulong daw sa either of the two foci. So, therefore, si linear eccentricity di is equal na siya kang C na itong ginote kaganina. No? Atong G, ginote na nga square root of A squared minus B squared. So, mauna dahil ni ang formula karon ni linear eccentricity. But, we're going to recall na si eccentricity is equal to diba, the ratio of the length of the from the origin padulong sa isa sa iyang foci all over semi-major axis. And we all know na kaning si C mao ni si linear eccentricity. Na linear eccentricity. So para makuha na to ni si C, transpose na to ni si A padulong kang E. So ang may tabo karon ang formula ni linear eccentricity is this one. Note lang nato si linear eccentricity as big letter E para dili ta mag libo, no? So out from that, linear eccentricity is equal to semi-major axis times first eccentricity, or pwede po siya mahimong katong kaganina nga square root of A squared minus B squared. Next is balik ya punta ning notation. So there are also another two quantities often used. We have also the third flattening, which is the, using this formula, no? Na A minus B over A plus B. And for third eccentricity, we have denoted as M, no? A squared minus B squared all over A squared plus B squared. And we have this relationship between the between flattening and eccentricity. So, from the eccentricity formula and flattening formula, we can get E squared is equals to 2F minus F squared. So, pwede nyo siya i-derive, no? I-prove ninyo nga si E squared is equals to 2F minus F squared. So, talking about the Philippine Reference System of 1992 or PRS 1992, Datum, so which is also formerly known as Luzon Datum of 1911. So, PRS 92 is defined by geographic coordinates of triangulation station of the Coast and Geodetic Surveys, which is known as Balanakan. Balanakan Station. So, mo ni ang point of origin or datum. Point of origin or datum sa Philippines for the basis of any surveying activities in the Philippines. So, money ang mga parameters. We have ang iyahang sphere is Clark 1866, We have the geoid sphere separation, which is N na 0.34, and coordinates na latitude north 13 degrees 33 41 seconds, and longitude niya east 121 degrees 52 03 seconds. So another about PRS-92. So PRS-92, or the Philippine Reference System of 1992, is a homogeneous national network of geodetic control points, or GCP, which is marked by monuments or mohons. And it is established using global positioning system, or GPS technology. So it is by virtue of AO45, dated January 5, 1992. The PRS-92 is now the standard reference system for all the surveying and mapping activities in the Philippines. Dapat ang mga coordinates sa any mapping activities in the Philippines must be in the PRS-92 na siya, na dato. So the order also mandated that the all new surveys and maps shall be referred to the new network, and all old surveys shall be integrated into it. So katong mga karaan nga surveys before, dapat i-integrate na siya into PRS-92. So we have also this WGS-84, another datum mission. So worldwide ni siya nga ginagamit. Worldwide adapted ni siya nga datum. Naa siya si may major axis nga 637-817. Iya hang si may minor 656-752.3142. Naa siya inverse latining nga 298.2572-23563. So it's all about WGS-84. So it is designated by NEMA, or National Imagery and Mapping Agency, as preferred ellipsoid and datum for all mapping and charting and geodetic products all over the world. So si WGS-84 is a geocentric coordinate system. So kung nag-geocentric, ang iyang center of origin is naa sa center sa ellipse, to ensure accuracy and easier user interface. And it provides a basic reference for mathematical figure of the Earth. And it also provides a means of establishing various geodetic datums to an Earth-centered or Earth-fixed or ECEF coordinate system.